The foreword for the book was written by none other than Nathan Buckley.
Yeah, I've known Bucks for over 20 years. He came to see me when I was in hospital in 1998, and we've been crossing paths ever since. So yeah, he came to see me in one of my major surgeries at the Royal Children's, and yeah, I've been in contact with him ever since. So it's really special. Have you got any more questions for me, Kara?
Does anybody else have any other questions?
I'll take some from the crowd if anyone wants to interview me.
How's being a father? That's something I was interested in hearing a lot about.
Well, it has my it has challenges. I can't do everything, and I rely on Isha a lot. And I love being a father. I try the best of my ability to provide for Shania and play with her, and yeah, it's really good.
And there is a little story in the book about when you drop Shania off at kindergarten one day, or
yeah, there is.
Tell that story.
Well, me and my best mate, he was staying up for the weekend, and we took Shania to school because Isha was getting ready to go to work, and yeah, me and my mate took Shania to daycare, and one of the teachers said, thank you, Dad. We'll see you at the end of the day. So yeah, she thought we were together or something like that. So I found that really funny. Yeah. She didn't recognise me and my mate. So yeah, it's been a while.
Excellent. Now, there's a few people you want to thank, isn't there?
Yeah, I want to thank Allsom Tadic, the bookshop in Kyneton, for your ongoing support of me and my journey of my book. And I want to thank Jamie and Glenn Harris from Cooking Crumbs and Sizzling Sensations for your support in helping me achieve my dream of selling my book, so you can also get it from there and enjoy a good coffee and a muffin. So yeah, you can go in there, and Jamie and Glenn will look after your cookie crumbs. So, yeah.
Okay, great. I've got a couple of people I'd like to thank because...
And one thing, I want to thank Hayden for his time in inviting me to the football club for this day and launching my book. So thank you, Big H. Really appreciate it. Everyone, a round of applause for Hayden. I was the first person with cerebral palsy in Australia to play AFL Oski. So people say I'm a bit of a pioneer of starting the inclusion for Oski and stuff. So that's pretty special.
Went up to Woolworths on my tricycle, and I asked to see the manager, and I handed my resume in. And yeah, he said he'll give me a go the next week. So yeah, that's how I started at Woolworths. So yeah, I spent 2 hours shoveling Bricky's head into Barrett. That was quite an experience. So I give everything a try, having a crack. So yeah.
Okay.
And people saying that it's too hard a history, I'll get hurt. Yeah.
Where you went to school in Kyneton. Football was always part of your DNA, wasn't it, growing up?
Yeah, I loved AFL and stuff.
A new book is revealing the strong bond between an AFL legend and the Magpie fan he describes as an inspiration. For 24 years, Nathan Buckley has marvelled at the courage of cerebral palsy sufferer Hayden Walsh, whose remarkable life story is now in print.
The same qualities that made Nathan Buckley a superstar.
Oh, yes.
32-year-old Hayden Walsh needs just to get through daily life.
Tenacious, positive, grateful, and just has a crack at life. It's a great example.
On Hayden's bedroom wall, a photo of their first meeting, Royal Children's Hospital, 1998.
It's a long time ago, mate.
Oh, no, I'm getting old with your grey hairs.
Don't worry, so am I.
Inspiring each other ever since, Bucks has written the foreword to Hayden's new biography.
I was very grateful for Nathan to think very highly of me since we've been crossing paths since I was a little boy.
Born with cerebral palsy, Hayden needed years of surgery and therapy to walk and talk. A footy fanatic, he played a Little League game at 11.
If anyway, then.
He's devoted to training with, helping manage and firing up the Kyneton Tigers.
We see Hayden struggles, physical struggles, but it doesn't define him. Yeah, he chooses not to be defined by it.
Now a dad, Hayden sees the book written by journalist Karen O'Sullivan as his duty to inspire.
If I can change one person, little kid with cerebral palsy, then I've done my job.
Nick McCallum, 7 News.